there's a lot of imagery in scripture if you get into it. A lot of it has to do with running the race or track and field or finishing strong. And so I have a baton here, and it really reminds me of what Brew and Brandon brought up this past week in 2 Timothy 1:13 through 18, where there's a charge of ministry. Someone once said that the race is won on the exchange of the baton. And so you can see perfectly here in scripture that Paul is passing the baton to Timothy, and he's saying, hey, here's the charge that I want you to have, and it's to fulfill the ministry. And so in essence, the baton is being passed from one disciple to another here in scripture. So it's really twofold, and there are two points that I think that Paul's trying to make here to Timothy, and one of those is to retain onto or hold onto the sound teaching that you have, that strong foundation that we're all familiar with if we're believers. Hold on to that. And what are we holding on to? We're holding on to the sound teachings of God's word and the scripture, and then also faith and love. So basically, trust in God and love your neighbor. If we were to be honest, sometimes that's difficult to do, even in some of the strongest exchanges. But there's more to that too, and it's to guard the treasure being the gospel. And so I got to thinking a little bit about that. It's a good thing, and we would all agree with that. It's a good thing. If it's such a good thing, then why do we limit exposure on 1 hour per week when every week consists of 168 hours? It also consists of 10,080 minutes. And if we break it down further, it consists of 604,800 seconds. The question I think that bears answering is, the charge to fulfill ministry is our duty, but what are we doing to accomplish that duty? Are you doing it today? Let me pray. God, I thank you for examples that we have in scripture here that play off in real life events. A simple baton that we have can be an easy reminder of the charge that we have as disciples of Christ, not only to connect ourselves to you, to others, but ultimately to the community and body of Christ. Father, Lord, I pray that that we can fulfill that charge, Lord, that we can love people, love God, and tell people more about Jesus. In your name we pray.